You have much to gain. I am Satsuki. I seek a keepsake of my father. Have you seen the sword inscribed Makoto? I will offer you demon swords if you can help me find it. You have found the Makoto, have you? Bless your good fortune, and, well, good work. Now, just hand Makoto over to me. Yes, yes, this is she. This luster, it's finally mine. But could this sword really be as deadly as this thing? There is only one way to find out.
Hello guys, this is Shaky Bees. What a cool little moment there. I randomly came back to Island's Edge and had that crazy NPC encounter there. We had a crazed guy that was looking for this sword, the Masuka I think it was called, and in the end convinced me to give it to him and then fought me to his death, unfortunately for him. It's a very cool moment and I love that about the Soulsborne franchise, that you can, you know, there's various little secrets just hidden away, and it does take you to loop back on yourself sometimes unexpectedly, go back to another area, and then suddenly there'll be something new to encounter. And I think, you know, it creates a bit of a puzzle, and you know, the replayability of these games is just incredible really on that basis. So cool little moment at the start there. So we're now going to fight the Storm King, which I've noticed a running theme with Demon Souls bosses. They're not an outright challenge. The only one that's been an outright challenge thus far was the Flame Lurker. That felt like a traditional Soulsborne boss, where it took me a long time to crack that one. Other than that, they're all quite puzzle based. I kind of like that though. It does make it feel like a very different experience. Again, the puzzle here is slightly ruined by the fact I've seen playthroughs of this, so I understood what I had to do. But I think if you hadn't and you were completely blind, this would be crazy. You'd be trying to figure out what it all meant for a while, I think. And I think that's the point of these games and these puzzle bosses. So yeah, really cool. I quite like the bosses in this game, but they're not an outright challenge. I think some of the end ones in Boletaria will be. But yeah, it's cool and it makes it a different experience. So we take out the Storm King. We also then subsequently move into the last area, the last Archstone, before we loop back to Boletaria and face the final boss. So we go to the dreaded poison area that every Soulsborne game has, and we take out a nasty looking boss there as well. So towards the end of this episode, you're going to see me take out the Leechmonger at the end. So there's two boss fights in this episode, so not too shabby. I'm going to keep my commentary pretty brief today and leave it there. Thanks for watching, thanks for any support you can give the channel, and yeah, all the best and take care. Have a great new year. Bye now.
Goodness, you're safe. I was worried sick. We are indebted to you for you fighting our behalf. I was worried sick.
I can forge weapons for you.
dead.
Thank you.
Is hungry. You don't deserve to die, so let me give you some advice. This place buzzes with pests fattened on a diet of souls. You could do worse than keep some lotuses for protection. The price of survival can never be too high, can it? How many years has it been since that witch Astraea came to this valley with that squid-headed knight? Those ridiculous white robes of hers. I swear I caught her glaring at my son in disgust. Yes, it's true. She's as nasty as they come. And she's a demon to boot. Not that it surprises me. You could do worse than keep the price of survival. Did my breath under that witch send you to torment me?
Yeah.